Hey family, I wasn't going to record this video. I was getting ready for bed, but there's a little girl called Zawadi and she's just on my heart today, and she will be. Everybody who sees this, I'm positive. The team went out on outreach in the local town for Angels Gate, and Angels Gate is our home for street involved boys, basically homeless boys who have been involved in drugs and crime and so on. When they were out there, they met up with a street worker of our, a former street worker who's currently now studying, and he took them to areas of concern, areas where addicts live, where heroin addicts live. Now, for those of you who don't know the background, many of the boys have been raped by these heroin addicts, or indeed were taught to be rapists. And already it's repulsive to us that these things happen, but where do you draw the line? Where does a child become man if a child's not educated? So they went to a derelict house, and in this house were 18 heroin addicts in total, they counted, that were there, all living together. But in there was a three-year-old girl called Zawadi, living with her father and her mother, both horrifically afflicted with heroin addiction, and said that, in the most part, they entrust God to raise her, meaning they go off and do their thing and leave her where she is in this drug den. The danger to her is incomprehensible, basically. So I let you meet this beautiful little girl and her father, and then once that's over, I want to share something with you.
Tuko pamoja. Yaani huyo Eric anaishi hapa pia yuko na mtoto mdogo chini ya miaka
5.
Sana kuja kushtua Dave kusema huyo.
Haina shida tatoka.
Why you hide your face? I
don't
Tenda.
you know, even I, after all these years, my immediate compassion is to Zawadi, who is little and innocent and sweet and needs protection and is only 3 years old. It's just natural, perfectly natural to protect the vulnerable. But one of the key skills I find we have to have in life to serve one another, to better humanity, to serve God, is to find a way to cultivate that same love and same vision on others, to see that vulnerability in them as adults, no matter what events have passed, no matter what they might have done to us, no matter what life course has taken them down, what mistakes they've made. It's very important that we understand that the father of this child was once himself a vulnerable child, and life has dealt him bad hands, and he is where he is. Her mother is the same. She's much worse, actually. She attacked the team, and that's why she's not on camera. How easy it is to see that and want to help Zawadi. But how, for many, it's overlooked that we need to help the parents too, because they too deserve it. They too are just as vulnerable, just as you and I. And I guess that is why we don't acknowledge it in adults, because we don't acknowledge how vulnerable we are ourselves. You were born into a world, there was no instruction manual how you were to be a human being, how you were to grow up. There wasn't even a guarantee if you had that instruction manual, it would go to plan, because you've got all these different variables going on inside society as well. And thus, you shouldn't view yourself too harshly. And in doing that, you won't view others too harshly. And if you recognize your own vulnerability, you'll recognize it in others too. And that was all I wanted to impart as well, without taking too much away from little Zawadi and her father and mother, was that. That it's so easy to see Zawadi and want to help her and forget the father. But we want to do both. So to do that, we need to get, first of all, Zawadi is coming into Feather's Tail to stay with us, not a permanent measure. Her father and her mother will enter heroin rehabilitation, and if God can reach them and keep them that way, then we have a victory. So to do that, we need to get them into rehab, so we're fundraising for that. We also need to find and establish a way that when they finish rehab, focusing positively that they will get through it, that they will need to set up and establish a family home and a small business away from town, because that's where all of the heroin usage predominantly is, and back into the more rural communities where they can have an opportunity to live the life they've told us they want to live. He told us, his father said, the father said, I'll leave with this, his last chance at life is his daughter. And he knows that he can't help her, and he can't afford rehab, and he has no idea how to stop on his own. So we want to help this family, and the link for the dedicated fundraiser is in the description box of this video. So Adi is safe right now. She's with our team. The mother and father signed a consent that she can stay with us for a little while, and we are now finding them a place in rehab. And hopefully, by the grace of God, we will have those resources as well. God bless, guys. Keep being awesome. Bye.
Give, always give what you can, even if your allies draw lines in the sand. And dig, always dig a little deeper, sometimes it's hard to be my brother's keeper. Love, so you let love in. Baby, I am home and awake of your skin, and it's crazy how we wear our ceremony. Always be open to your path and your journey. Yes, she cradles my loneliness, a home at our forest nest. Universal test, feel the weight of my love. Put your hand on my chest and rest. In the cradle of my arms, the battle that we face is a place where our scars come from. And to pick up the gun, my love, we are destined to teach these ones to be brave and never run away. Courage is birthed from the womb on the first light of day. The other day you were born, you came out perfect, never meant to be torn in silence. Never been so loud in the violence, never been so proud of a people. When we're fighting for a change, not afraid to lose it all. Despite all the rage, we are animals and we cannot be caged. Provoke us to fight, so we burn a little sage and write poetry. Wiser than the enemy will ever be, the minority and authority. Are you here to protect or arrest me? I can't tolerate the hate and I'm losing sleep. Can't breathe cause they're choking out a war in me. Immorality, yeah. Love letters to God. I wonder if she reads them or if they get lost in the stars. Stars in the stars. So many parts to a heavy heart. If there's no beginning, then where would you start? Start, start, where would you start?